A very good morning to each one of you. Now in this 11th part, we are going to discuss quantum mechanical model of an atom. After the new developments, that is dual nature of matter and uncertainty principle given by Heisenberg and the other studies, they gave the drawbacks to the Bohr's model, which was the perfect model for the explanation of structure of an atom. But after these discoveries gave a setback to Bohr's model. Then the scientists, they started looking for such a model which can include both dual nature of matter and uncertainty principle. Ab iske liye, during their studies, they come up with the quantum or wave mechanical model. This mechanics was first of all discovered by Schrödinger. He gave a function which is termed as psi. This psi is termed as wave function, which is associated with the electron, because we are considering electron as a wave here. Now wave, it propagates three dimensionally, that means in x, y and z axis, and this psi was explained in or calculated in all the three dimensions. So accordingly, Schrödinger gave a wave equation, curly square psi upon curly x square along x axis plus curly square psi upon curly y square along y axis plus curly square psi upon curly z square along z axis plus 8 pi square m upon h square into e minus v psi is equals to 0. This equation was given by Schrödinger. Similarly, for the system whose energy doesn't change with time, he gave the equation h carry psi is equal to e psi, where h carry is a type of operator known as Hamiltonian operator. It is just like a mathematical operator that we use in mathematics, like plus, minus, multiply, divide. Similarly, h carry is a type of operator termed as Hamiltonian operator here. Initially, these equations were not easily accepted because this equation, this is the simple one and this is its complicated differential form. These were the complex equations and they were not accepted initially, but later on the solution of the equations, they were coinciding with the experimental results, and the experimental result and the results of this, the solution of this equation, they were that much coinciding that this equation was greatly accepted. Now here we are using the term psi. What psi is giving us here is, it is giving the amplitude of the wave which is associated with the electron. We have discussed it earlier also, what psi is, this is the amplitude of the wave. If we represent the wave in this way, the amplitude is the maximum displacement of the wave from its mean position in crest as well as in the trough. So this is the amplitude of the wave and psi is representing this amplitude of the wave. But now we are concerned here, in an atom we are concerned that where the probability of finding the electron is maximum. We are concerned with the location of the electron in it. So for that, if we do the square of the psi, this gives us the value of intensity of an electron in at any point, that is probability of finding the electron in a region, means outside the nucleus, means in an atom outside the nucleus, we are concerned with the location of the electron, that where it is located. It is, now here we have discussed that electron is moving in the form of wave. If it is moving in the form of wave, means that means there is a probability of finding the electron around the nucleus. So to find that probability, to find where the electron is, the value was given to us by squaring psi, that is psi square, means if psi, the value of psi square is more, means the probability of finding the electron in around the nucleus is more. And if the value of psi square is 0, means in that area the probability of finding the electron is negligible, that is equal to 0. and that region where the probability of finding the electron is zero is termed as node. Now, the probability of finding the electron in a region around the nucleus, we term that part where the probability of finding of electron is maximum as orbital. In the next part, we will discuss what orbital is and how it is different from orbit. Now, the significance of psi is that it gives us the amplitude of the wave, and psi square gives us the probability of finding the electron. The region around the nucleus where the probability of finding the electron is maximum is termed as orbital. To understand the orbital, till now we have done that suppose this is the nucleus and around this there are shells in which the electrons revolve. The shells which we have discussed till now here, they were termed as orbits. In these orbits, the electrons, they go on revolving with particular energy, and hence they were also known as energy levels. Now, what is the difference between this orbit and what this orbital is, what we are talking about? Orbital is the space around the nucleus where the probability of finding the electron is maximum. Why so? Because we have considered electron here as a wave. If electron is like a wave, means that around the nucleus, the electron is not moving in this only this fixed path. Electron sirf isi path mein move nahi karna. But as compared to it, if this is the nucleus, this is the space around the nucleus where the electron is moving in the form of wave, and the probability of finding the electron in this region is maximum. So we can say that orbital is the region around the nucleus where the probability of finding the electron is maximum, and orbit is only the circular path in which the electron is revolving. In the last, we have discussed this also, that electron propagates in the form of wave three-dimensionally. If it is propagating three-dimensionally, means in x, y and z axis, means the orbital, means the region around the nucleus where the probability of finding the electron is maximum. These orbitals, they are also extended three-dimensionally in x, y and z planes. Accordingly, the electrons which are moving in the form of waves along x, y and z axis, there are three different shapes in which the probability of finding the electron is maximum. For that, orbitals, they are of four types: s, p, d and f orbitals. The shape of s orbital is spherically symmetrical. The shape of p orbital along axis is like this, dumbbell shape. Along y axis is like this, again the dumbbell shape. And along z axis is like this dumbbell shape. Means in this orbital, the probability of finding the electron is maximum along x axis, along y axis, along z axis. And in the same way, for d orbitals and f orbitals, the shape are double dumbbell shape. So, on the basis of this, now we are going to differentiate between orbit and orbital. What orbit is? It is the well-defined circular path around the nucleus in which electron revolves. Suppose this is the nucleus and the electron is revolving around it. This is just the orbit. And what the orbital is? It is the region in the space around the nucleus where the probability of finding the electron is maximum. Means orbit to apni jagah par hi hai. Lekin us orbit mein electron hai ya nahi, that is not necessary, that whether the electron is there in it or not. But orbital is the space where the probability of finding the electron is maximum. Second difference is it gives the definite path. See here, this is the definite path which we are observing, that electron is revolving around the nucleus. But here it doesn't specify the definite path. Suppose if it is in s orbital, then it is spherically symmetrical. If it is in p orbital, then in which p orbital? Along x axis, along y axis, or along z axis. So its path is not definite in the orbital. Next is, it is always circular. Orbit is always circular. क्योंकि orbit क्या है? सिर्फ एक रास्ता है जिस पर इलेक्ट्रॉन घूम रहा है. But here orbital they have different shapes. Spherical, dumbbell shape, double dumbbell shape. In the same way for F, diffuse dumbbell shape. Next is, in case of orbit, we have studied that it can accommodate electrons which is equal to the formula which was given, 2n square, where n is the number of shell. Suppose if we are talking about first shell, then value of n is 1, square of 1 is 1 into 2, that means first shell can accommodate maximum of 2 electrons. Talking about second shell, a value of n is 2, square of 2 is 4, 4 into 2 is 8, means second shell can accommodate maximum of 8 electrons. Similarly, third shell can accommodate maximum of 18 electrons. But on the other hand, n orbital have the maximum tendency to accommodate 2 electrons only. So here the number of electrons to be calculated in an orbit is calculated by this formula 2n square. And here the number of maximum electrons in one orbit is 2 only. Then this next point is, it doesn't have directional property because it is a circular orbit only. Orbit is circular in shape only. Here it has directional property except s orbital, because s is spherically symmetrical, p is dumbbell shape, and d and f are double dumbbell shape. So on the basis of this, the difference in orbit and orbital is clear, that orbit is just simply the space around, circular path around the nucleus in which the electron revolve, and orbital is the probability of finding the electron around the nucleus. Thank you.